1940s, you remember a different world. In fact, it was another era. An era most Americans look back at with nostalgia. The war, for some of us, was still something happening to other people in other places. There wasn't even any TV. Comedy, drama, music, and especially news, war news, reached us through the radio. The things we did then may look funny to us now, but even in those years, love was thriving, and that great American institution, football. It was a simpler time, the way we were. For one group of people, a station master in Los Angeles, a doorman in New York, a movie producer and director, a college professor. Those times and places have a particular meaning. All are involved in the making of a new motion picture called The Way We Were. This is Union College in Schenectady, New York. For Richard R. Kyler, professor of theater, changes have been few and subtle. Teachers and students have walked this same campus for 178 years. It is an ideal location to begin to recreate an era, starting with those college days of the late 30s. So when a movie company arrived, little in the atmosphere had to be altered. For Barbra Streisand and Robert Redford, the campus would be home for several weeks. Here they would film scenes of their first meetings. Here would begin their love story.
Stop the slaughter of innocent women and children. Do something about it. Write your congressman. You do it today.
Hey, Katie, what are you selling?
Stop. The ROTC, you can have it cheap. Fascist.
The professor was in for something of a surprise when director Sydney Pollack chose him to sit next to the speaker's platform in a scene where Barbra Streisand addresses the student body. The filming itself is a most demanding task, and it calls for a unique collaboration between the director and the producer, Ray Stark. For Stark, the shooting is the culmination of many months of planning and preparation. Today, the scene is a peace rally. Imagine a time when the Atlantic Ocean still separates America from the rest of the world.
There's only one thing to be scared of. And it's not me. And it's not the red bogeyman. You'd be scared of anybody, any place, who will not stand up for world peace now.
For Robert Redford, the role of a campus hero comes easily. His natural athletic prowess fits many of the demands of the character he plays. But beyond the athletic achievements is a depth and attitude and ability that enchants those around him, on the campus and in the classroom.
Class. It's because I think we learn best from what's good, or at least talented. Today, I'm going to read, with a great deal of pleasure, a remarkably good story from a surprising new source. The name of the story is The All-American Smile, and it's by Hubbell Gardner. In a way, he was like the country he lived in. Everything came too easily to him.
The college prom was the big event in those years. Romances were started, and if you didn't have to go into the service, civilian life was still exciting. New York was the center of activity for those who found themselves involved after college.
Oh, listen, we gotta stop FDO. We just got her. I'll take them. I'll give them to your friends. I'll help you out.
The city hummed with people, especially around Broadway or at nightclubs like the famous El Morocco. Uniforms were everywhere. It wasn't unusual for people who hadn't met in years to find each other in places like this and recapture that special excitement of old college friendships.
Small world, isn't it?
I fall asleep.
I think so.
What do you know?
Across the nation, Hollywood had its share of excitement. But then, the movie capital was always in the public's eye. For those who came here right after the war, the lifestyle was overwhelming. Beverly Hills homes were luxurious, and the stars, producers, writers, and directors who gathered to play often held parties. For people like Katie and Hubble Gardner together and working in Hollywood, it's a time for having fun.
Too high? Too low? Oh, you're trying to tell me something. What? He's here? In the room? Should we leave?
You can have 10 years in Leavenworth, 11 years in 12worth, or 5 and 10 in Wilmington.
The film company moves to Hollywood to recreate a Groucho party. And the man himself visits the set. Like the college professor and all the others, he remembers the way things were and recalls with Barbra Streisand the large part he played in giving glamour to the movies when he and the Marx Brothers were at the zenith of their popularity. Shooting the party will consume days of work. Much of the time is devoted to planning the placement and movement of people. To record all the outrageous, wonderful Groucho Marx-inspired comedy lines.
Honk, 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 said the duck.
You rang? Your wishes went good.
Morning, I shot an elephant in my pajamas. How he got there, I'll never know.
What are you hungry for? What do you want?
I'm hungry for your absence.
At Union Station in Los Angeles in the 40s, the comings and goings of big stars was constant and cause for great public notice. Today, Union Station is almost a big commuter barn. For station master Kenneth Bradley, who's been here for 40 years, things return to the way they were when the movie company reconstructs an era he remembers very well. Preparations are made to film an important sequence here. Barbra Streisand, Lois Childs, Robert Redford, and director Pollack will play out an episode in the lives of the two former college classmates. The station master has a part in the movie. He doesn't need much in the way of rehearsal to play himself, and the time he recalls so well, the time of the late 1940s. Stars like Barbra Streisand returning from Washington on a political issue, Robert Redford, her husband, coming to Union Station to meet her train, caught up in a crowd of demonstrators. Another sign of the times.
It's always fun meeting trains, no?
I'm sorry, Hubble. I really didn't expect this.
You didn't expect to come to Hollywood and get a chance to tell off the world either, did you?
Is that what you think I'm doing?
You bet I do.
Those years and events are gone now, and the movie company has moved on to another location. But for a little while, Union Station echoed with all the old excitement this station master remembers so well. The picture spans the years from the late 1930s through the early 1950s. The years Joseph Sorrentini watched pass by as doorman of the Plaza Hotel in New York. Now he watches as the movie makers assemble to bring back the mood and memories of some of those years. His beloved Plaza, the ultimate hotel, the cars, the clothes, the atmosphere of the place that adds special meaning to a moment when two who were in love meet again. How many times he's watched as scenes like this unfold in reality. Together, Barbra Streisand and Robert Redford are filming a love story. They are taking us back through the years we look at with fond memories. Together, they are bringing back the very special, unforgettable time of the way we were.
Simply choose to forget.